Good afternoon, everyone. I am Edjan Peñaflor, and we will tackle about Chapter 14, which is Designing and Managing Services. The nature of services. The Bureau of Labor Statistics reports that the service processing sector will continue to be the dominant employment generator in the future economy, adding about 18 million jobs between 2010 and 2018, or about 88% of the expected increase in total employment. By 2020, the goods producing sector is expected to account for 11.9% of total jobs, down from 12.4% in 2010 and 16.8% in 2000. Manufacturing lost a staggering 5.7 million jobs from 2000 through 2010. These numbers and others have led to a growing interest in the unique opportunities of marketing services. Service industries are everywhere. The government sector, with its courts, employment service, hospitals, loan agencies, military services, police and fire departments, postal service, regulatory agencies, and schools, is in the service business. The private non-profit sector, museums, charities, churches, college foundations, and hospitals, is in the service business. Categories of service mix. The service component can be a minor or a major part of the total offering. We distinguish five categories of offerings. 1. A pure tangible good such as soap, toothpaste, or salt with no accompanying services. 2. A tangible good with accompanying services like a car, computer, or cell phone with a warranty or a specialized customer service contract. Typically, the more technologically advanced the product, the greater the need of high-quality supporting services. 3. A hybrid offering like a restaurant meal of equal parts goods and services. People patronize restaurants for both the food and its preparation. 4. A major service with accompanying minor goods and services, like air travel with supporting goods such as snacks and drinks. This offering requires a capital-intensive good, an airplane for its realization, but the primary item is a service. 5. A pure service, primarily an intangible service, such as babysitting, psychotherapy, or massage. The Panera Bread. Founded by Ron Sachs as Boston bakery called the Cookie Jar in 1980, Panera Bread has emerged over time as a leader, with Chipotle in the fast casual restaurant category. Panera combines the speed and convenience of fast food with the quality and menu variety of waiter service dining. The chain targets food people who understand and respond to food, or those on the verge of that, by selling fresh, real food at full prices. Customers are more than willing to pay. An unpretentious atmosphere, no table service but no time limit, encourages customers to linger. The brand is seen as family-oriented but also sophisticated, offering fresh baked artisan bread and a full menu of healthy, good-tasting sandwiches, salads, soups, and breakfast foods. Panera has innovated in a number of different ways, infusing a strong social conscience in much that it does, with the slogan, "Live consciously, eat deliciously." CMO Michael Simon leads a number of social and community initiatives such as the Panera Bread Foundation, collaboration with Feeding America, and donation to local hunger relief agencies and charities. The company has opened 5 Pay What You Can Panera Cash stores. In other marketing areas, it has boosted its digital spend and boosted a loyalty program with 14 million members, accounting for almost half its transactions. Now, let's go with distinctive characteristic of services. Four distinctive service characteristics greatly affect the design of marketing programs: intangibility, inseparability, variability, and perishability. Intangibility, unlike physical products, services cannot be seen, tasted, felt, heard, or smelled before they are bought. A person getting cosmetic surgery cannot see the result before the purchase, and the patient in the psychiatrist's office cannot know the exact outcome of treatment. To reduce uncertainty, buyers will look for evidence of quality by drawing inferences from the place, people, equipment, communication materials, symbols, and price. Therefore, the service provider's task is to manage the evidence to tangibilize the intangible. Service companies can try to demonstrate their service quality through physical service evidence and presentation. Suppose a supermarket wants to position itself as the fast supermarket. It could make this positioning strategy tangible through any number of marketing tools. Number 1. Place. The layout of the checkout area and the traffic flow shall be planned carefully. Waiting lines shall not get very long. 2. People. Checkout staff should be busy, but there should be a sufficient number to manage the workload. 3. Equipment. UPC scanners, credit card readers, and electronic registers should all be state of the art. 4. Communication material. Signage and brochures, text and photos should suggest efficiency and speed. 5. Symbols. The supermarket's name and symbol could suggest fast service, for instance, Speedy Shop. 6. Price. The supermarket could advertise a $10 rebate if customers have to wait in line more than 5 minutes. Inseparability. Where various physical goods are manufactured, then inventory, then distributed, and later consumed. Services are typically produced and consumed simultaneously. A haircut can be stored or produced without the barber. The provider is part of the service because the client is also often present. Provider-client interaction is a special feature of service marketing. Buyers of entertainment and professional service are very interested in the specific provider. Variability. Because the quality of service depends on who provides them, when and where, and to whom, services are highly variable. Some doctors have an excellent bedside manner. Others are less empathetic. Service firms know the variability in their performance puts them at risk. Hilton initiated a major program to create more uniformity in guest experiences. Hilton Hotels. Between 1964, when Hilton Hotels sold its foreign licensee, Hilton International Corporation, and 2006, when it bought it back, the two companies operated largely independently, and as a result, the Hilton brand was no longer providing customers with a uniform high-quality experience. Nomura Research Analysis Harry Curtis said, "The brand standards in Europe were always very different from those in the U.S. I think they were quiet, frankly, a bit slacker in Europe." Chris Naceta, appointed CEO in 2008, initiated H360, a project to review everything from breakfast fare to VAT amenities, the decor of lobbies, Wi-Fi service, hotel architecture, and handling of customer complaints at all the company hotels. Naceta said, "There was a huge amount of inconsistency in their granular standards that travelers care about. As a result of H360, independent owners of Hilton-branded hotels in the United States and abroad have been forced to upgrade to Hilton standards where necessary or be dropped from the Hilton system. Protecting the brand seems to have served the company well. By 2010, the company had the highest brand equity of nearly 40 hotel chains. Service buyers are aware of potential variability and often talk to others or go online to collect information before selecting a specific service provider. To reassure customers, some firms offer service guarantees that may reduce consumer perception of risks. There are three steps service firms can take to increase quality control. 1. Invest in good hiring and training procedures. Recruiting the right employees and giving them excellent training are crucial, whether they are highly skilled professionals or low-skilled workers. Better trained people exhibit six characteristics that improve service quality: competence, courtesy, credibility, reliability, responsiveness, and communication skills. 2. Standardize the service performance process throughout the organization. A service blueprint can map out the service process, the points of customer contact, and the evidence of service from the customer's point of view. Shows a figures 14.2 shows a service blueprint for an overnight guest at a hotel. Behind the scenes, the hotel must skillfully help the guest move from one step to the next. Service blueprints can be helpful in identifying potential pain points or customers, developing new services, supporting a zero defects culture, and devising service recovery strategies. 3. Monitor customer satisfaction. Employee suggestion and complaint systems, customer surveys, and third-party comparison shopping. Customer needs may vary in different areas, allowing firms to develop region-specific customer satisfaction programs. Firms can also develop customer information databases and systems for more personalized service, especially online. Perishability service cannot be stored, so their perishability can be a problem when demand fluctuates. To accommodate rush or demand, public transportation companies must own more equipment than if demand was even throughout the day. Some doctors charge patients for missed appointments because the service value the doctor's availability exists only at the time of the appointment. Demand or yield management is critical. The right service must be available to the right customer at the right places, at the right times, and right prices to maximize profitability. Several strategies can produce a better match between service demand and supply. The new service realities. Service firms once lagged behind manufacturers in their understanding and use of marketing because they were small or they faced large demand or little competition. This has certainly changed. Some of the most skilled marketers now are service firms. One that wins consistent praise for its brand building a success is Singapore Airlines. Singapore Airlines, SIA, has been consistently recognized as the world's best airline, in large part due to its stellar marketing. The carrier wins so many awards, it has to update its website monthly to keep up to date. Famous pampering passengers, it continually strives to create a wow effect and surpass customers' expectations. SIA was first to launch on-demand entertainment system in all classes. Dolby Sound system and the Book the Cook service that allows business and first-class passengers to order meals before boarding. Thanks to a first-of-its-kind $1 million simulator, the airline built to mimic the air pressure and humidity inside the plane. It found that taste buds changed in the air and that, among other things, it needed to cut back on spices in its food. New SIA recruits receive 4 months of training, twice the industry average, and existing staff get nearly 3 weeks of refresher training a year, costing $70 million. With its stellar reputation, the carrier attracts some of the best local graduates and staff each flight, with more attendants and other cabin crew members than other airlines. SIA apply a 40-30-30 rule. 40% of resources go to training and motivating staff, 30% to reviewing process and procedures, and 30% to creating new product and service ideas. A shifting customer relationship. Because U.S. consumers generally have high expectations about service delivery, they often feel their needs are not being adequately met. A 2013 Forrester study asked consumers to rate 154 companies on how well they met their needs and how easy and enjoyable they were to do business with. Almost two-thirds of the companies were rated only okay, poor, or very poor. Retail and hotel companies were rated the highest on average, and internet, health service, and television service providers were rated the worst. The highest-ranking companies were Marshall, USAA Bank, Amazon.com, Kohl's, Target, Courtyard, by Marriott, Sam's Club, Rite Aid, Costco, Lowe's, TJ Maxx, JCPenney, and Marriott Hotels and Resorts. Service providers receive low marks for many reasons. Customer complain about inaccurate information, unresponsiveness, rude or poorly trained workers, and long waits. Even worse, many find their complaints never reach a human ear because of slow or faulty phone or online reporting system. They say companies mishandle online complaints by responding selectively, inconsistently, or not at all, and by cutting and running, appearing insincere, or attempting to just bribe the consumer. Customer empowerment. The digital era has clearly altered customer relationships. Customers are becoming more sophisticated about buying product, support, service, and are pressing for unbundled services. And the right to select the elements they want, they increasingly dislike having to deal with a multitude of service providers handling different types of products or equipment. With that in mind, some third-party service organizations now service a greater range of equipment. A plumbing business may also serve air conditioners, furnaces, and other components of a household infrastructure. Customer co-production. The reality is that customers do not merely purchase and use a service. They play an active role in its delivery. Their words and actions affect the quality of their service experiences and those of others, as well as the productivity of frontline employees. Customers often feel they derive more value and feel a stronger connection to the service provider if they are actively engaged in the service process. This production can put stress on employees, however, and reduce their satisfaction, especially if they differ from customers culturally or in other ways. Moreover, one study estimated that 1/3 of all service problems are caused by the customer. The growing shift to self-service technologies will likely increase this percentage. Achieving excellence in service marketing. The increased importance of the service industry has sharpened the focus on what it takes to excel in the market. Marketing of services. Marketing excellence. Marketing excellence in service requires excellence in three broad areas: external, internal, and interactive marketing. External marketing describes the normal work of preparing, pricing, distributing, and promoting the service to customers. Founder Tony Hsieh, customer service practice at online retailer. Supposed are widely admired and studied. Internal marketing describes training and motivating employees to serve customers well. Arguably, the most important contribution the marketing department can make is to be exceptionally clever in getting everyone else in the organization to practice marketing. Interactive marketing describes the employee's skill in serving a client. Clients judge service not only by its technical quality. Was the surgery successful? But also by its functional quality. Did the surgeon show concern and inspire confidence? In interactive marketing, teamwork is often key. Delegating authority to frontline employees can allow for greater service flexibility and adaptability because it promotes better problem solving, closer employee cooperation, and more efficient knowledge transfer. Charles Schwab, one of the nation's largest discount brokerage houses, uses the telephone, internet, and wireless devices to create an innovative combination of high-tech and high-touch services. One of the first major brokerage houses to provide online trading, the company today serves more than 8 million individual and institutional accounts. It offers account information and proprietary research from retail brokers, real-time quotes, and after-hour trading program. The Schwab Learning Center, live events, online chats with customer service representatives, a global investing service, and market updates delivered by email. It has also been adding a few a slew of mobile capabilities to satisfy its customer on the go. Schwab grew during the financial crisis by offering new products for sophisticated investors, such as managed portfolio ETFs and fixed income funds. Besides the discount brokerage, the firm offers mutual funds, annuities, bond trading, and now mortgage through its Charles Schwab Bank. Its success has been driven by its efforts to lead in three areas: superior service online via phone and in local branches offices, innovative products, and low prices. Its long-running talk-to-chat marketing campaign reinforces how the firm is always there to help its customer. Technology and service delivery. Technology is changing the rules of the game for services in a very fundamental way. Banking, for instance, is being transformed by the ability to bank online via mobile apps. Some customers rarely see a bank lobby or interact with an employee anymore. Technology also has a great power to make service workers more productive. When U.S. Airways deployed handheld scanner to better track baggage, mishandled baggage decreased almost 50%. The new technology paid for itself in the first year and helped contribute to a 35% drop in complaints. That's all. Thank you.